the company's Moy Ortiz launches an online workshop that aims to help songwriters. And this is something that you can think about, this ECQ, and it's actually good for your mental health. We have with us Moy. Good morning to you, Moy.
Good morning, Karen. Thanks for having me on your show, and good morning to all of your audience.
All right, let's start first with you are the accidental songwriter, but then before writing, you now have 400 songs to date. Why did you start this songwriting workshop?
Well, this was a suggestion by my manager. Her name is Stella Season of Stages Talents. Of course, we know what happened last year when the whole world shut down in March. We were trying to look to, you know, just like you and everyone else, to pivot our core skills digitally and online because the company couldn't do any shows anymore. So what we, what Stella suggested was that we try to come up with short video snippets of our core competence, like the two members of the company, Annie and Sweet. They teach now online via Zoom, and they have students all over the world. For me, I decided to do songwriting, but it was initially meant to be like 10-minute snippets, webisodes, but it morphed into something else. And now we have this 10-episode video on demand workshop series on songwriting.
Okay, but can everybody learn to write songs?
In a way, the basic premise of this video workshop is songwriting is storytelling. Okay. The way it's produced and written, this is really more for beginners and hobbyists. Mm-hmm. So don't expect anything that is music theory heavy.
Correct.
But basically, the thrust is we are here as storytellers so that our audience can relate to universal human emotions that are relatable.
Yeah. So you can, songwriting, will you be teaching them just how to write the song or even compose the song in terms of finding the tune?
I mean, it starts from, to answer your question, yes, Karen.
Yes,
melody, lyrics, and it even goes as far as how to market, how to distribute your composition.
Mm-mm. And frankly speaking, anybody can record a song now. All you need is a laptop, honestly, and then you can even just put it out on Spotify, right?
That's true.
Yeah.
This whole digital world has democratized the music industry. In fact, Karen, you can even record on your smartphone now, and it goes straight to the aggregate, and it goes on Spotify.
Yes.
It's that easy now.
Okay, how does, you know, with the ECQ, people end up taking painting, or they go to an online course, or they learn to cook, if you've noticed, right? Many have become like the baker, the chef. But why would songwriting be a good option to consider this ECQ, or even as we extend into another form of lockdown?
Songwriting, I feel, is it's an opportune moment now to get into your hobbies that fill the well of your soul. So
yes,
this is good for you on a emotional, psychological, or mental level. Songwriting is like that. It tries to pick your brain and try it. Pump primes you to become creative and to express yourself. It's all, you and I know that communication is key, and to be able to express whatever you feel, especially now in the pandemic, whether it's fears, hopes, anxieties, and dreams, to be able to express that in music is a healthy thing and a healthy choice to do right now.
Mm-mm. And writing music is a form of therapy too that can help your mental state.
I totally agree. Totally agree. Whatever you have inside or whatever you're going through, if you are able to put it on pen on paper, and in this case, in songwriting, to express it musically, you not only help yourself, but you also help other people there, so that people don't feel isolated and alone because they can relate to whatever you're going through.
And how many people are you accepting in a class? I mean, you have 10 episodes, so to speak. So that's 10 sessions. And it's quite reasonable because you're only charging $599 per session, right? Or per episode. Why do you call it episode, Moy, and not sessions?
It's an episode because this songwriting workshop series is a video on demand product. In other words, the person who's interested in getting this can either download one episode, kung medyo gipit tayo sa budget, or download all 10 episodes. Just to make it clear, it is not a live class. It is a video on demand. So you download it. You can have your inquiries and you can enroll and register on the Facebook page of Stages Talents or the Instagram page of Facebook Talents. Uh-oh. But what makes this different, Karen, from the other master classes on songwriting out there is that the students will have direct access to me. They can email me if they're having problems or challenges with a certain assignment. Every episode has an assignment and you have a goal to fulfill. And this is wonderful, Karen, because we all know it.
But do you meet with them after? For example, I just get a few episodes, right? And I start writing. How do they feel a sense of achievement or fulfillment if they're not comparing notes in a class?
I will serve as their mentor and I will give them honest feedback. They have free access to me via email. And if it goes so far as a collaboration with a student, then so be it. I'm really open to anything. Although I do see your point, it's really different to have a physical class, unfortunately not physical, it's not possible.
Not physical, but at least an online class. Yes, an online class where you're live.
I see.
Then all of you meet each other. I'm just curious. Yeah.
Yeah, I hear you. Of course, that has different advantages also. But because this songwriting from a songwriter video workshop is meant to enhance you and not to add more pressure. So the students can and should learn at their own pace and at their convenience. I've been teaching also at Mint College since last year, and
teaching online now. You're teaching online at Mint?
Last semester, Karen.
Okay.
And sad to say, well, let's destigmatize it. I have a lot of students who cannot deal with the online system right now, and they have opted to quit the class because so many pressures, you know, it's a lot to handle. Yes. So with this, what we're offering, the student can learn at their own convenience, at their own pace. So no pressure, really. The point is to enjoy the journey and there are no deadlines. So I'd like to enjoin your viewers to come check out Songwriting from a Songwriter.
Okay. And where do they, how do they connect with that? I mean, I do know there's a form, there's a link that's been sent to me, but then where do they find that? What do they search?
Yes, Karen, thank you. Please go to the Instagram page or the Facebook page of Stages Talents, and they can do their inquiry there. They can get the episode per episode or the entire course. Just send a direct message to those places.
How has your life changed, Moy, with the pandemic? I mean, all of us, of course, our lives have changed, but I'm curious in terms of you.
It Okay, wow. I didn't see that question coming, but that's a good one, Karen. It has forced me to simplify and forced me to reassess and recalibrate what is essential, what is needed in order to have a joyful and fulfilling life. But having said that, Karen, I don't mean to brag. I'm just being honest here. Yeah, yeah. Since last year, it's been very, very creative in terms of projects, great, you know, and in terms of writing songs. I think I believe I've written 8 songs since last year.
Well, and I'm so happy to hear that because it means that at the height of the pandemic, you chose to channel your creativity, right? To doing something worthwhile instead of being stressed and frankly watching Netflix all day, which many people end up doing.
Okay. Not that there's anything wrong with that.
Nothing wrong with that, but it's amazing. It's amazing that you've chosen to come up with more songs.
Yes, I believe so. There is always, well, this is a personal conviction. There is always a reason even for the difficulties that we go through life. And instead of moping and being self, I think that's the way how I am wired. But of course, I do not impose this type of thinking to other people out there. But it's really been busy. This workshop has taken me a full 11 months to write, produce, edit, and film. And on top of that, with my partners, Ryan Keabyab, Noel Ferrer, and Maribel Garcia of the BGC Arts, we're coming out with a brand new musical in November.
Really?
And this fall, yeah, it falls under Pinoy Playlist Music Festival at the BGC Arts in Taguig. Of course, it's online. And it's a brand new musical about the pandemic. So all of the feels about this pandemic, the light feelings and the deep
but
feelings.
You don't want that. I mean, you don't want that to be shot on film and then be shown on some, like a place like Netflix or View or iWonTV. That would be, that's a possibility. I'm seeing musicals now. There's one right now on the Hispanic community, right? That's on Apple TV. So I'm just curious. It's very difficult to write a musical, period. And if you can, won't you want that immortalized on film?
That's exactly, Karen. Thank you. You hit the nail on the head. That's exactly what we're doing with this pandemic musical. It's called The Pinoy Pandemic Palabas. We have commissioned several composers, Ryan Keabyab, Louis Ocampo, so many, Joey Ayala, the Itchy Worms, and it will be filmed and it will be shown on November 6th and the next Saturday for free on the YouTube channel and the Facebook channel of the BGC Arts. This is our gift to the world. New music, new OPM music that talks about real stuff, what everyone is going through during these difficult years.
Mm-mm. All right. My last question, and you didn't see this coming, is since you've written so many songs and you are a singer yourself, is I want you to sing just even, I don't know, one of your songs that you feel resonates well during this time. And, yes. And I do know that your hero, so to speak, is... You've named Michael Legrand, Jimmy Webb, Joni Mitchell. I love Joni Mitchell.
Yes, man.
Michael Mazur. And locally, of course, it's a given. Ryan Keabyab, Louis Ocampo, Odette Quesada. So I've read an interview that you've done. And I was hoping that you could sing before we go because we are heading into the weekend.
Of course. A little... Oh my, I didn't warm up, but that doesn't matter. Come as you are. I want to sing a song of hope. This was written by myself and Edith Galliardo, a song of hope. It was written as a love song, but now through a different lens in the pandemic. Pagdating ng panahon, baka ikaw rin at ako, baka tibok ng puso ko'y maging tibok ng puso mo. Sana nga'y mangyari yon, kahit di pala ngayon. Sana ay mahalin mo rin pagdating ng panahon.
I love that. My God, bravo to you.
You're kind.
Thank you. No, really, thank you for that. That was like just singing it cold right there, right? No,
scary.
But nothing. No, but really, actually, when you sang it, I'm familiar with that song. I know that song well. Pero it had a whole different meaning that you sang it now. You know?
Especially the bridge. Di pa sigurod bukas, di pa rin ngayon. Malay mo balang araw, dumating rin yon. That is now my prayer that we live to tell and we learn the lessons of this pandemic.
Okay, and I'm downloading that on Spotify right now. And everybody, after hearing Moy sing, it just gives you all hope that you might be able to write a song with those kinds of lyrics, that kind of melody. So I'm encouraging all of you, please check out the Stages Songwriting Workshop. Just Google it. And then already check out all the video on demand episodes where he will teach you how to write songs all the way down from your musical profile down to modes of speech, singing your melody. It's very specific. So thank you so much, Moy. God bless you.
God bless you. And thank you. This was a wonderful conversation. Take care.
Take care, Moy. Take care. All right.